When a Zap exchanges information between apps, the apps usually understand each other because they're speaking the same computer language. But sometimes, miscommunication can happen if information from one app is in a format that looks weird to another app. With Zapier's formatter tool, you can transform text, numbers, and other data into the format that you need. Say you're building a Zap that sends a customized email to people who fill out your Google form. Your form asks for full names, but you only need their first name for the email. It would sound strange to use someone's full name for a custom email, right? So you add a formatter step to your Zap, and it will split the text into the format you prefer. And that's just a simple example. There's so much more you can do with the formatter that we'd need an entire course just to show you everything. So instead, let's briefly go over the four main things formatter can do. Transform text. Formatter's text action can perform simple operations like capitalization and replacing text, or more complex options like extracting a piece of text, converting markdown to HTML, or even removing HTML tags. Transform numbers. You change the format of a number, currency, or phone number. Formatter's numbers action can also perform math operations and spreadsheet-style formulas. Let's say you have a consulting side business. You want to create a Zap that sends estimates from QuickBooks Online after someone fills out a type form. But you use a particular percentage to calculate your estimate, based on the size of the company. You can add a formatter step between your trigger and your action to calculate your price. Transform dates and times. Formatter can add or subtract from a date or time. It can also reformat dates. For example, perhaps a date coming into your trigger app is in international format, but your action app needs it in American format. Formatter's date time action can convert the date to your desired format before sending that information to the next step. Perform utility functions. Formatter's utilities action can import CSV files and convert text to line items, among other things. Let's say you're using a Zap to gather WooFoo submissions in a Google Sheet. Your survey asks each person for the top 5 activities they want to do on your team retreat. The information comes in as a comma-separated list, but you're only interested in their top choice. You can use utilities to pick from a list before your Zap sends that information to your spreadsheet. To recap, Formatter is like an all-purpose tool for your automation toolbox. When the information from an app isn't in the format you need, Formatter can transform it into something you can use. Formatter can transform text, numbers, dates, and times, perform utility functions like picking from a list, and so much more. These four are just the tip of the iceberg. Now that you understand some of what Formatter can accomplish, try playing around with it. That's the best way to get comfortable using Formatter. We'll see you in the next lesson.